You can see the slides now. Okay. So just I have talked about scalar and vector quantities. So so scalar are one thing. Scalar are the quantities which can be defined with a single value. So like temperature, volume, mass, etc. So like if you want to quantify a temperature, we do not need to specify the direction, in which direction the temperature is there. We can say that it is 45 degrees Celsius. So nobody will ask us in which direction it is 45 degrees Celsius. Everybody will understand that the object has got a temperature of 45 degrees Celsius. So this is a scalar quantity. Similarly with volume, nobody will ask that in which direction the volume is this much is centimeter cube. Nobody will ask. Here they will know that it is 1 centimeter cube, so it is 1 centimeter cube. So now the vectors are something different from scalar. A quantity which should be defined by a vector quantity, it should also it should know the magnitude of that quantity as well as the direction in which direction that that vector is pointing. Like if you want to specify the if you want to just if you are walking, okay, so anybody can ask in which direction you were walking. So you have to tell that I'm walking with 10 meter per second in north direction. So you need to specify the direction, that is the velocity. Okay, so people can know that you are walking in north direction. So but the most important point of this specifying a direction is that you have to specify the reference axis. You need to specify the reference axis to specify a direction. Like if you are saying that you are walking in north direction, then you have fixed the north direction in your mind or in the convention, in proper convention. If you are saying that I am walking 45 degree to north, then you are specifying the north as to be the reference point. Similarly, if I ask that write to me, see write to me. So what you are doing, you are putting me as a reference and then seeing towards the write to me. So always a direction will demand a reference direction. So that is the most critical point to observe. And we have in engineering terminologies we have defined many coordinate systems. Like the one which I have which you can see on the slide is a two axis rectangular coordinate system in which you define your x axis and y axis. Okay, with reference to your x axis you specify any vector. So here you can see the vector which is put at 45 degree to the x-axis. So this vector is having a magnitude, that is v mod v, which is the length of this vector, and the direction of this vector is 45 degree to x. Okay, so a vector will need a direction. Okay, now we need to somehow analyze more than one vector. When you go into using these vector quantities, then you might be needing to add up two vectors, subtract, multiply. So we need to learn that how to do that. So this is just a review of vector and scalar quantities. So you might have gone through these things very well, but let me review it. Okay, so adding two vectors, how we you can add two vector if there is a v1 sorry, okay, so I can just redo this. Okay, fine. Now let me say this has to be v1 vector. Okay, and this has to be a V2 vector. We need to add this. So how we can do it? We can take this V2 and shift here. Okay, how we can shift the tail of this V2 will be coinciding with the head of this V1. Okay, and the final vector will be V1 plus V2. This V1 plus V2 will start from the tail, from the origin of these vectors, and it will head towards the head of V2 vector. So you can always see that V1 plus V2 will be equal to V2 plus V1. What we say this as to be? This is commutative law. So how you can verify this? Just see that here we are. What we are doing? We are shifting this V2 in here. We can also shift this V1 onto here. So you can see if we shift this V1 onto here, then also we will get the same vector V1 plus V2. So this is this verifies this, that if we add V2 to V1, it is equivalent to adding V1 to V2. This is called commutative law. Then after adding the V1 to V1 plus V2, we can also add a VC quantity, a V3 quantity. So how we will add this V3? So let me take another color. So let us say this is V3. So if we want to add this V3 to V1, what we will do? We just need to shift this V3 to V1 plus V2. So this can be this is V3 here, and now this would be your V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay. So we can see that we are adding these things, but let me make it this has to be clear that if we are adding V3 to this V1 plus V2, we get this blue line. You can see we have done this. Similarly, we can also do this thing V2 plus V3. We can add these two, first V2 plus V3 and then add V1. So you will see that this will result into the same vector V1 plus V2 plus V3. So what this law is called? This is called associative law. So if my voice is breaking, then you have to just speak out because I am on some other slide. Okay, so I am not at the meeting slide, so I will not get the notification. So you can just post your queries in the chat box, and I will after completing my lecture, I will see through that, and I will try to answer that. Okay, so this is cumulative law and this is associative law. Okay, then another method of this vector addition is this thing. So what I am doing, I am completing the parallelogram. So I am completing the parallelogram with this has to be the consecutive sides. So this is your parallelogram. So V2 is equal to V2, V1 is equal to V1, and the diagonal is your V1 plus V2. This is the diagonal of this parallelogram will give you V1 plus V2. Okay, then we need to subtract also. So what is the subtraction? V1 minus V2. We want to do to subtract one vector quantity from another vector quantity. So this is what we have to do. So this is just rewritten in this form, in addition form. So what we are doing, V1 plus minus V2. It means we have reversed our V2 vector. This is our exactly plus V2. Okay, this we have to subtract from this quantity. So what we are doing, we are reversing this. Let me take another color. Okay, so we are just reversing this V2. So this is minus V2. Now we can add these two, V1 and minus 2. So what we can do, we can just complete the parallelogram. So this is this thing. It should not be an arrow. Okay. And this one. So what will be the diagonal? Diagonal element will be this thing. We have to add V1 and minus V2. So this is the diagonal. So what this is? This is V1 minus V2. Okay. So this is how you can just subtract two vector quantities. Then comes scalar multiplication. What is this scalar multiplication? So what is the scalar multiplication? Scalar multiplication, you just multiply two scalars. So they will be represented by just quantities. So let us say V1 is a scalar quantity and we are multiplying it to be V2. Let us say this is 2 unit and this is 3 unit. So this will make you 6 unit. Simple. This is just like multiplying two things. So when you multiply a scalar quantity to a vector quantity, then what you are doing, you are just multiplying the magnitude part. The vector part will remain the same, means the direction part will remain the same. If you are multiplying a vector V1, that is 2, let us say 45 degrees. Okay, this is the angle with the x-axis, so you can always relate. And V2, let us say this is 3. So when you multiply a scalar quantity to a vector quantity, so this is the vector quantity, we usually draw an arrow sign above a vector. So if we multiply a V1 vector into V2, so what we will get, we have to multiply the magnitude. So this is 6 and the angle will remain same. Okay, but this is not V1, this is V3. There is a difference between V1 and V3. Okay, V1 is having lesser magnitude, V3 is having larger magnitude. So these two vectors are different. So a scalar multiplication, a scalar quantity multiplied to a vector quantity gives you a vector quantity. It will always have a direction. So, scalar is simple. Then what about vector multiplication? Vector multiplication is a thing which we will deal in some other lecture. But before that, let me discuss one more very important property, or say important principle in which you can represent your vectors. So we will be seeing a different a different dimension of your vector. Let us just see that. More than speaking, I should write. Okay, so we are having a vector, let us say. So this is x, okay, and this is y. Okay, and we are having a vector that is b. Let us move very slowly, okay. Let us not hurry. You know everything, but let me review it. Okay, so this is a vector v. Now, how much this vector, you know this vector is at, let me specify, this vector is at 45 degree to x-axis. But how much this vector is in x direction? And how much of this vector is in y direction? Let me speak one more. So see, this vector is in neither in the x direction nor in y direction. It is in 45 degree to x direction. So let me make the component of this vector. So this will be v, let us say x. Okay, and let us say this has to be vy. So vy is the component of vector v on y direction, in y direction, and vx is the component of v in x direction. So if you want to represent this v, we can say this is vx in some ax direction. Okay, in some direction, let me say x-axis direction. Plus, this is also plus vy. Vy is the component of v in y-axis direction. So you can see we have broken our vector v in two components. We have broken our vector v in two components. One component is in x direction, one component is in y direction. So we have broken it in two vectors. One vector is in x direction and one vector is in y direction. Now a direction can be defined by a unit vector. So let me define a unit vector first. So unit vector. What is a unit vector? So a unit vector is having magnitude 1. Okay, and it has a direction. It has a specific direction. Okay, means the fixed direction which we are noting. Or let me call this a vector ax. Let us define the vector ax. This is a unit vector. We used to define a cap over this ax to represent it as to be a unit vector. All the unit vector will be represented like this. So there will be two unit vectors, ax and ay. What is ax and ay? Ax and ay are just the are having a magnitude, unity magnitude. It will be having one, and it will be having a particular direction. So here this ax is in x direction, oriented in. This is ax is oriented in this direction. Okay, and magnitude is one. Okay, and we are having a ay in this direction. So let me take a different color. This will be easier. Okay, so this is what? This is ay, unit vector ay. So we have defined two unit vectors. One unit vector is in x direction, one unit vector is in y direction. Now just see how we can use this. So we can define this v. We are not using these two unit vectors to define our v. So v is equal to vx into ax. I will give you time to think over that I have written the correct thing or not. Is vx ax equal to vx? These two things are equal or not? Is it good enough for you to assume this? Because vx is what? Vx is the magnitude. This vx is the magnitude of this vector, and the direction is in x direction. So ax defines the direction and vx defines the magnitude. This is scalar quantity. Vx is a scalar quantity and ax is a direction. So vx into ax will give you a vector. Vx ax, this is your vector. Now you can simply for the same thing you can do for vy to define vy. So this will be vy into ay. Good enough for everyone to understand this. Take your time and just think over it. That is it fine or not? Okay, let me give you a task. I asked you to bring a pen and paper. Okay, so the task is to find a unit vector in the direction of this v vector. Can you find a unit vector? You know what is a unit vector? Unit vector is having magnitude 1 and the direction and a particular direction. So you have to find a unit vector in this direction. So tell me what is unit vector. This, what will be the expression of this unit vector? So everyone just write it down in your copy, in your paper. And you can just turn on your video and show me this.